Hi, I'm Carl Conrad, and I started Australian Immigration Law Services 22 years ago. We are an experienced team of registered immigration agents based in Sydney, and we help people in Australia and across the world to get the visas to live, work, and study in Australia. If you want to learn more about Australian visa requirements and keep up to date with the latest immigration news, subscribe to our channel and turn on that notification bell. Now, if you're applying for a partner visa, the four aspects of the relationship are essential in demonstrating your relationship is genuine to the Immigration Department. Today, I'm going to talk about our final aspect of the four aspects of the relationship, the nature of the commitment. The partner visa is meant to be used only for very serious relationships where the couple has the intention of spending their lives together. This is why you either have to be married or in a de facto relationship. It is also the reasons why there are rules about trying to sponsor more than two people in your lifetime and why sponsorships should be at least 5 years apart. It's only natural then that the nature of your relationship is an important factor to the Immigration Department. If you want to learn more about partner visa and other aspects of the relationship or the sponsorship limitation, you'll find the links to all of these videos in the description below. You can also get to our partner visa playlist at the very end of this video. So how are you going to prove the nature of your commitment? A shiny diamond ring just isn't enough, or indeed the fact that you live together. There must be a level of commitment in the relationship, and the onus is on the applicants to demonstrate this. The standard factors the Immigration Department looks for are as follows, but they are not the only possible indicators. How long you have been together. How long you have lived together. Remember, there can be reasons why a couple are not living together, and this can be considered also. The degree of the relationship and the emotional support that you give to each other. And if you both consider the relationship to be one for the long term. Now, proving your commitment to each other to a government body may seem a little daunting, but you may be surprised to learn that you already have the evidence on hand. These four aspects of a relationship are considered as a whole picture of the dynamics of your particular circumstances. The Immigration Department may also ask for an interview with one or both of you to see how well you know each other's lives and families. They can even also turn up on your doorstep unannounced and ask to be let in to conduct an assessment. And I've written an article about this, in which you can find in the link below. Ultimately, the Immigration Department simply wants to establish that the relationship is genuine, continuing, and that partners have a mutual commitment to a shared life to the exclusion of all others. It is important to note that having multiple partners is not acceptable by the department. If you're new to our channel or missed our previous videos, I really recommend that you check out the related videos in the description box. There's been a lot of new news regarding partner visas, such as a huge increase in quota for partner visas, priority processing for those partners in the designated regional areas, as well as the upcoming new English requirement for partner visas coming next year. If you're looking for more information, head over to iminews on australiavisa.com. We also do Skype and Zoom consultations, so book a time if you need more help. Follow us on Facebook and don't forget to subscribe. And as always, take care out there and bye for now.